हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई होप यू आर डूइंग ग्रेट एंड एंजॉइंग दिस सीरीज ऑफ पिक माइक्रो कंट्रोलर एंड यू आर मोस्ट वेलकम इन माय यूट्यूब चैनल वाइल्ड लूप रोबोटिक एंड ऑटोमेशन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट बिट कॉन्फ़िगरेशन ऑफ पिक कंट्रोलर, सो लेट अस गेट स्टार्टेड। दिस इज एलईडी ब्लिंकिंग कोड, सो हियर इज सम पार्ट। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू कैन सी वी हैव टू सेट सम बिट कॉन्फ़िगरेशन। You can see this is oscillator bit selection and watchdog timer bit selection, power up timer, brown up reset, low voltage, data EEPROM memory code protection, flash program memory write enable bit protection, flash program memory code protection bit. Configuration bits specify sum of operating modes of microcontroller. These are read during the reset and enable or disable the hardware features of microcontroller. So these are compulsory to configure in every project. So I will show you how to configure this. So first of all, go to production and click over here, set configuration bit. So I will click here. You can see it's open. This is FOSC. FOSC is oscillator selection bit. So click here. You can see here is EXTRCHS, XT and LP. LP is low power frequency crystal and XT is crystal resonator, HS is high speed crystal and RC is external resistor capacitor. So in case of LP, LP has lowest current consumption and it select lowest gain setting for the internal inverter amplifier and it designed up to 32.768 kHz. And XT is crystal oscillator, so it select intermediate gain for the internal inverter amplifier and typically its range is up to 4 MHz. And HS select highest gain setting for internal inverter amplifier and it has highest current consumption and typically used with crystal above 4 MHz frequency. And in case of RC, we use external resistance and capacitor to produce frequency. So I will select HS. Watchdog timer, second is watchdog timer. We can face a situation like if controller is not working properly. In this case, we mostly reset the microcontroller by reset button. But it is not good to use reset button for solving it every time. To overcome this situation, we use a watchdog timer. Watchdog timer is an electronic timer which is integrated in microcontrollers and is used to detect and recover from a problem. It is a simple counter that gives pulses to restart the microcontroller unit. The output of the watchdog timer is given directly to the microcontroller reset signal. It is actually a free run counter where our program needs to write 0 in every time it executes correctly. 0 will not be written if the program gets stuck and the counter will reset the microcontroller upon achieving its maximum value. So if you want to enable, so turn on, and if you want to disable, so turn off. So I will enable this, so I will turn on. This is PWRT, power up timer enable. I will explain you power up timer enable. When a reset occurs, the quick startup of microcontroller again can cause problems. So to avoid such condition, a fixed स्टार्ट अप डिले ऑफ 72 मिलीसेकंड इज प्रोवाइडेड बाय दिस टाइमर। इट डिलेस द पिक माइक्रोकंट्रोलर यूनिट, द ऑपरेटिंग वोल्टेज VDD rises to its full value. So this process ensures that the supply voltage is stable before the clock startup. So if you want to, when power up timer is enabled, then it creates delay when device will be in reset state. Okay, so if you want to enable, so you can select on, and if you want to disable, so you can select off. Okay, I will select off. Brown out reset enable bit. This is brown out reset enable bit. When a drop in voltage comes or the voltage become less than threshold voltage, RAM memory may get corrupted and the device will not run properly. This condition is called brown out. Brown out reset when enable resets the device if the supply voltage VDD drop below the brownout voltage for the longer time than brownout time. Once this situation occur, the device will remain in brownout reset until VDD rises above the brownout reset voltage. So here brownout reset voltage is near about 4 voltage and brownout reset time is near about 100 microsecond. So if you want to enable, so you can turn on, and if you want to disable, so you can turn off. So I will use, so I will turn on the brownout reset timer. So I will turn on the brownout reset. LVP. LVP is low voltage signal supply. These microcontroller can be serially programmed. This allows customer to program the microcontroller just before shipping the product. When using ICSP, it must be supplied at 4.5 to 5.5 volt. The LVP bit of the configuration enable low voltage ICSP programming. It will allow microcontroller to program through ICSP by using VDD source within the operating voltage range. So in short, we can say that VDD does not have to bring to high voltage. Okay, so I will turn off this. You can turn on and turn off anything. So I think turn on is right thing. CDP. This is data IP ROM memory code protection bit. PIC16F877A has an internal IP ROM data, 2 bits CPD and WRTD protect the entire data of IP ROM. External read and write of data IP ROM is controlled by CPD. CPD configure bit protect the region of memory against reading and external recording. So if you want to protect, so you have to select 0 means off, and if you want to disable, so you have to turn on. You can see here is off, so IP ROM protection off. If you select on, you can see IP ROM protection is on. Okay, here is IP ROM code is protected. WRT, it is flash program memory write enable bit. These bits enable writing in flash memory by the use of EECON. We can write data directly into the flash memory by the device firmware. Simply, we can say that the sector of our choice can be selected for the recording of data or for the in-circuit serial programming. So, I think you can do turn on and turn off. So I will turn off this. CP is flash program memory code protection bit. In this program, if the program is stored in the flash memory, then this bit is responsible to enabling the code protection. So if you want to protect, you can turn on, and if you want to not protect, so you can turn off this. After that, you have to generate the code output. So you have to select here, generate source code. I will click here. See, this is the code. Copy all this thing and you can paste here. See, I will do comment all this thing. See, this is bit configuration setting. So friends, I hope you enjoyed this, and if you really like my video and my work, so you can support me on Patreon and PayPal. The link of Patreon and PayPal has given in description box. Thanks for watching.